Hey guys, in this video we will go through different IQ test questions and solve them together. I will go task by task and explain you how you should solve them. For those who don't know me, hi, my name is Sava and I'm a freelance product and interaction designer. And this YouTube channel is a side project of mine where I talk about things I'm generally interested in. And last year I did a supervised Mensa IQ test and I scored 144, which means I'm in 99.83 percentile, and I'm intellectually gifted, and I have paper for that. See? Yeah, it's kind of like meaningless. The questions we will be looking at are from Czech online Mensa IQ test, because, you know, I believe not that much of you know Czech language, so, you know, I just screenshot the questions from there, but, you know, you don't need to know any language for solving IQ puzzles. And I choose some more easy ones and some harder ones. And so, like, you know, usually in IQ tests, these questions are kind of distributed through the test, so it doesn't mean that you are starting with easy ones and then you are getting to hard ones. But in my version of IQ solving video, I'm starting with easier ones and getting to harder ones. That's generally the rule applied here. And if you like talking about IQ, I made a video a while ago about my experience going through Mensa IQ test, about IQ test history and what IQ means anyway. And it's one of my most watched videos so far, so you can check it out. I will link it down below in the description. And yeah, without further doing, let's jump into the video. So guys, let's dive into the examples. And I prepared, let me see on my computer, I prepared 7 examples. They all have different difficulties, and I tried to cover as much different topics in IQ tests as possible, because there is, like, generally speaking, some kind of questions or some kind of tasks, but they are repetitive. So if you know the thinking behind, then you probably will be able to solve it. So I tried to combine a lot of different ones. And let's look at example one, which is kind of easy. So first thing first, as you can see, there are 3 aspects which we are looking at. First one are these, let's say, borders. One is solid, one is dashed, and the whole picture is rotating like this. So I drew here arrow, but basically you kind of flip the image, and so as you can see, the dashed border will be on top and solid border on bottom. Then the second thing which we are looking at is that it's square, and this square has a cross in the inside of it, and this cross becomes double cross. So as you can see, it's basically the one which I circled over there. But this example is really easy and probably everyone should solve it. Next one. So this one is probably even more easier. We are just looking at colors and shapes. So, you know, we will have a circle with four beams, let's say beams, which have green color. That's kind of easy. So example number 3. So over here, it's a little bit more complicated, and we have 3 things. So it may be kind of harder, but we will make it together. So as you can see, there are certain shapes in the picture, and these shapes doesn't change. So if we look at, you know, what are possible solutions, we will just focus only exclusively on ones which have shapes, like same shapes as the third row of this example. And as we can see, there is only one such a solution, and also there is a rotation applied, so it will be this one, the one I marked. I would say, regarding to this example, I would say if there is a lot of stuff going on in the image, in a question, try to focus on, like, on certain parts of it which you know that are, you know, same for each of one of, you know, for each image from the following sequence. And yeah, focus just like on small parts, go through each different part and see some like, you know, patterns through it. If they are matching or if they are rotating or if they change color or shape or whatever, don't try to focus on all of it because it's a mess and it should trick you. Basically, it's full of different shapes because it should trick you. But you are a smart person when you are watching this video and you don't want to be tricked. Okay, example number four. It's loading. Okay, so this is a classical sum example. There is, you know, basically some of these examples will have some mathematical operations in it. And this one is sum. Basically, you just like sum these images. So as you can see, you just like put one on top of another. That's in another word sum. And it's the solution number one. Very easy. But you know, there can be, you can extrude something, for example, in some images, even divide something. I saw it over there when I was doing my test in Mensa. So think about mathematical operations. Okay, example number five. So this one is sequence one. And how I know it? Well, it's classical sequence one. These dashes, which are like in the middle of shape, or you know, it's like a border. So one is solid, one is dash, and one is just like dotted. And they have certain sequence. And you know, you can't see it on the first line, but you know, I wrote down this sequence like down here. And as you can see, first is solid, then it's dash, then it's dotted. And you know, after dash, it's dotted, and then it's solid again. So this way we know that it has certain sequence. We can kind of draw it down or, you know, remember it. And so we know what's after solid line, that it's dashed line. So we know that it will be something with dashed line. And there are only two possible solutions with dashed line. Now, we know that it will probably be a triangle, because as you can see, the first row are only ellipses, then we have squares, and then we have triangles. So it's triangle and it's green one because the rows follow colors. So it's basically, you know, three things which you need to consider in order to do the solution. But in this particular case, it's example on sequence. And yeah, there will be probably like 2 to 4 sequence examples in the real Mensa test. Now, sixth example. Okay, so this one is actually kind of hard. And it's hard because, well, or actually, like for me, it's hard and I should be intellectually gifted, but we can solve it. Or I can solve it and you can too. So first thing first, as we can see, there are only shapes, like on every row, there are only the same shapes and every row has the same color. So we know that we are searching for something that is red and that has the same shapes or as, you know, on the previous examples. And as we can see, there are only two such things, one thing which we should note is that this last shape, so on first row it's triangle, on second row is minus, and on third row it's square, are not moving anywhere. They are constant and only three remaining are kind of shuffling around, probably following some sequence. So, you know, I'm trying to simplify that and we are not trying to find the sequence. We are trying to, you know, find out the quickest possible solution. So we will look at solution which has the same shapes and the square is not moving. So yeah, it's the one which I noted. And now let's look at seventh example. And this one is on rotation. And so basically, and rotation colors and shapes. So it has three components, so it's one of the harder examples. Usually easy ones is like two components to it. This one has three components to it, to the solution. And as you can see, this like middle row, middle dash or middle minus or whatever it is, kind of says which direction of this pattern will be in the shape. So at the first, at the first shape, the pattern is, you know, like this at the first time, but you know that the thing in the middle says, okay, pattern will be like this. So now pattern is like this. Same on second row and on third, same on third row. The important thing is that first column has yellow in it and the last column has blue in it, a blue pattern. So we are searching for something that is blue pattern with this sort of direction of pattern in it. And is first, as you can see. So yeah, hope my lovely writing and circling stuff helped you to navigate across these examples. So guys, hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, you should smash the like button or press subscribe button or any other of these things which YouTube algorithm likes. You know, we are playing YouTube game here and it's kind of standard and you know what to do. But one last thing before you go to watch market videos is that I see IQ tests as some sort of like puzzle, which is fun to solve, not as something which would like determine your life or anything. So you should not judge anyone based on their IQ results, even if they are high or low or whatever. So I'm interested in this sort of topic because I generally like solving different puzzles, playing chess, programming on computer and stuff like that as fun. And that's probably what it is. It's not a big deal for me, at least. And I'm talking about it more in my IQ test video, so you can definitely check it out. And hope you had a nice day and see you soon next week on next week's video.